Whoa. There goes another big one. I kid you not. Another big one. I don't know if that's the same fish. He was right there and went over there. Scared to think what's back in here, but I'm gonna just fish these out here. This is where I've been catching, out in the outer stuff, not in the inner stuff, the outer. So let's keep going along here and fish this outer stuff. And hopefully that wasn't, well, maybe it was the same fish, but he sure scram pretty fast.
Check it out.
That's a nice fish. Right there. Ugh. Not the one I saw, but nothing wrong with that, boy. Whew. Did you ever pound that? I mean, just pound it in the pad, see? Making your pitches. You talk about using sharp hooks. I mean, I use the sharpest stuff you can buy. No playing around, man. Really. On good days, when they're suicidal and just eating everything, that's one thing. But I mean, wow. He was not, I mean, not coming off, was he? Through the back cheek. Let's put him in there. Maybe 2.5, 2¾. Look at the backs on them. Nice looking fish. Oh yes. One of your buddies. Wow. Whew. Getting comatose. Dizzy. Not drinking enough water. But catching bass in the nasty. The pitch and stick. You see what I mean about making those pitches all over? Two things. Power pole, stay down, make the pitches, put it in, and let them have it. Just shake it, yo-yo it, up and down, keep moving. Don't just soak an area, wasting your time, you know? Keep moving, find the fish, so you're going fast and slow. What's fast and slow? Fast is you're picking apart those deeper outside ones. So every fish we've caught, all four, have been on the outside edges of the pads, so. Do you keep working the inside? It's very tempting, but time constraints. Work the outsides first. If you don't get any fish, then maybe go back and fish that deeper, thicker stuff that has the real condensed pads. But so far, so good. Thanks to the Pitchin Stick Legend Tournament Bass. Let's keep going. Let's get one more that I saw that swam.